you, but them not ready yet. Make them not say your thing ever ready set. Them a chat, but them never ever matter yet. Expensive.
Guys, welcome to Real Life with Ron. I'm back today with another video. And if you're not subscribed, what the fuck are you playing at? Go subscribe now. Like, comment, all that good shit. Do that now. Don't forget to do that. Also, I feel like I'm not always going to do videos with makeup. I just want to be real with you and just give you the real me since I've named myself Real Life with Ron. But yeah, when I get time, I like to make videos and just edit and then post them when I can, because now I've got 2 children, not one. So bear with me. I've got a Q&A. I was meant to do it time ago, but I felt like because my channel was growing, there was no point in doing a Q&A straight away. So I have asked some people from Instagram, and I have asked some people that follow me that I know and don't know a couple questions that people want to know, or what they think people might want to know, what they want to know that they might not know. So I've got a couple questions here. I'm going to answer it. It's on paper, written down. Obviously, I can't use my phone because I'm using it. So I'm going to get on that now and just give you all the questions and answer them. So number one is, how old are you? I'm 24. Yeah, I'm 24. And I'm born in 1995, obviously. Describe yourself in 3 words. Oh, I would say loving, passionate, and strong. I'm loving, I'm passionate, and I'm very strong. Even though I don't feel like I'm mad strong. There's times where I have the bad days and there's times where I have the lit days. But yeah. What country are you from? Well, I'm from the UK. I'm from London. I'm from England. But my mum's Ugandan, British Ugandan. And my dad's Jamaican, British Jamaican. When I say British, I mean like they're from Britain. They're not born in Uganda. I'm born in Jamaica. But my mum says that she was born in Uganda as a baby but brought back here when she was 6 months. That's what she told me. What area are you from? Well, I'm from a lot of areas, joking, but I was brought up in Crystal Palace, and then I moved to Peckham. I used to live in Queens Road, and then I moved to Wharf Road, and then I moved from Wharf Road, and now I've moved now and I'm moving again. So yeah, but I'm born, I would say I was from South London. That's where I grew up. Why YouTube? I feel like I'm a person that likes talking. I like expressing my feelings. I like showing people what I've been through to give them help and give them something to look up to when they're feeling like they haven't got a clue, or they feel like they need things to like link to get through things. So I just want to do YouTube just to like motivate people, like inspire people, help people if they just need something to watch to get through a situation, or to see how I'm doing stuff to see if they can do it in that way to help them. So I'm kind of just doing YouTube to help others, but at the same time I like editing. I like being creative with how you like add effects, take effects out, write things, put things together, videoing my life experiences. Like even on Snapchat, I love filming food, and I'm just kind of that person. So I feel like it all kind of links, and it's kind of becoming a passion now. Obviously, I am a teacher, but I feel like as a side hobby, this is basically my hobby. And if it does pursue and it goes big and it grows and people start watching me and it clicks off, I'll be so grateful. I'll even start taking it proper serious and making it another like career, but for now it's just a hobby. Do you have a boyfriend or a husband or partner? Yes, I do have a partner and a husband. I kind of show him here and there, but not really a lot, because he doesn't really want to be in the limelight right now as he's trying to finish off studying and get into his career. But I do have a partner, and I do show him on Snapchat sometimes, and I think once or twice on my channel. But because he wants to pursue his career, I don't put him in my business a lot. And I feel like we've seen it as well, when you do put your relationship into social media, like too much problems happen. So we like to just keep our relationship intimate. But if you know my story, I do speak about him in my story, because the way we met and how we're even here where we are now, it's a big thing to me. So I do, like, he's a big thing to me, like the way it happened, everything, our situation is just amazing. So yeah. What was the next question? What do you want to become in life? So at the moment I'm a teacher, and that's kind of what I wanted to become in life. I originally wanted to be a youth worker, but I started doing teaching and I did nursery work in the past and youth working in the past, but I feel like teaching kind of sums me out, because I like working with children, I like working with young people, and I feel like from primary to secondary they're kind of in between. So I'm doing primary at the moment, I'm going to go into secondary, and I love it. Like, the main thing is helping people. I love helping people. I like helping people get to their goals. I like motivating people. I like expressing my feelings to help others with their feelings. So it's good. Like, I love the kids, they love me, and it's been amazing. So my career is a teacher, but I did want to be a youth worker, and I did do a bit of nursery work, play work in the past. What's your favorite color? My favorite color is blue. Don't even know how I've got blue nails when I'm doing this Q&A. My favorite color is blue, but I do love gray now, and I've kind of done like a white and gray theme in my house. I don't know why, don't ask me why, but I have got it going on in the house now. So I would say blue, but I like royal blue, but then there's times where this blue can get to me as well. And I do like gray and white, but blue is the main one. What's your favorite food? I would say Chinese, but I'm kind of growing out of it, because there's times where I like African food. My partner's not Jamaican. Everybody thinks he's Jamaican, he's African. I like African food. Now that I'm with him, I'm kind of more into it, because I went boarding school, I already had a thing for Ghanaian food already. So I love Ghanaian food, I love Nigerian food, and I love Chinese. But yeah, I'm in between, because me and my partner cook so well that I can just eat things that are like made from yard. Like, I can make these kind of things that you see in the restaurants in my yard, like fried rice, jollof, roasted chicken or beef, lamb, prawns, fried prawns, all this good shit. How many siblings have you got? I've got 3 brothers. I'm gonna try to finish this because my son is back and he's awake, and I don't really want to be showing him until he is bigger, but until he's 1. I didn't show my daughter on social media until she was 1. I used to show my bump and little things, but I never showed her face until she was 1. When I had her first birthday, everybody was like, "You got a child?" I was like, "Yeah, I had a child." But if you see me on road, then you would know, because I used to have a long jacket, and because she was born in the winter time, I was always closed off, so my body parts weren't out. Whereas my son, because we did it in more of a better way, that means like everything was done proper. We done it more revealed, as in the stomach, because I showed like I had maternity shoe and all of that, so everything was done more out there. Anyway, you said, how many brothers do I have? I said I have 3 brothers. What school did you go to? I went to English Martyrs when I was young, and I went to another primary school before that. It was St. Francis Cabrini. I think I even went to another school before that, but I can't remember. Secondary school was Michael Ramsey and Crofton, but it's called Prendergast now. And college was my St. Charles College, is in West London. And uni was Luton, Bedfordshire, but I left. And yeah, that's it. Sorry guys, when I'm rushing, I'm trying to get my point across. I talk fast, don't mean it, it's just natural. I've been doing it from young. Like, if I really want to get shit out, I just talk fast, but I don't mean it. But one more question. It was, what's your favorite music? Well, I like all types of music. I like Christian music when I'm in the mood for it. I like R&B and slow jams when I'm in the mood for it. I like trap and drill when I'm in the mood for it. And yeah, it just depends when I'm in the mood for it, basically. But I love a lot of things. Like, there's a lot of music that I love. I even want to do another playlist. That playlist, sorry guys, I had to just post it, because the intro bit when I was saying, "Hi guys, welcome to my channel," it got cropped out, and I had to just go with it, because I didn't want to not give you guys the content, because I really wanted you guys to know my music flow and what I like. So I just posted it. By the time I even it loaded, it now showed me that the intro was cut, and I was like, "Oh, I'm not doing this whole video again." When I do a gospel playlist or something, that's when I'll just make sure I don't fuck it up. Do you get it? But I was not gonna do that whole one again. That would have been too long. And what else did I want to apologize for? In my sweet packs video, I had a little an emoji and little writing that gave you like the real life with ones 25. That's the code, discount code, if you want to get sweets, like a pack of sweets or a box of sweets. The code came out so tiny, because basically I've transferred from my editing now. I don't edit on my phone, I edit on a laptop. So the content changed, so it came out different quality. I was so pissed because I was like, oh, they're not going to understand why it looks like that. But I still posted it because I just want to give you guys the content and I want to practice and I just want to go for it. Like, you're never going to be perfect in this stuff. As long as you can just come with clean content and people can see you and understand, move with it. That's what I felt like when I got advice from Nicole, Fia. So yeah, that's what I'll be doing. And anything else I wanted to talk to you guys about? Yeah, I think that's it, you know. Oh yeah, sometimes when I want to play like little music in the background, I have to be careful. So if you don't hear me playing my jams that you normally see me playing on Snap, it's not my fault. It's because of copyright. They chat bare rubbish. I tried to do Zariah's birthday, my top 10 playlist. No, not my top 10 playlist. That one went through because it was like a minute of each song. But yeah, Zariah's birthday vlog, I tried to do Drake instrumental in the background and they said it was copyright. They blocked the whole thing and took it off, so I had to play it back with something from like the editing app music that's on the editing app. That's what I had to use. It's not easy doing this stuff all, but I'm gonna try and see and get advice from people that actually been doing this stuff for long and say like, if you do want to put our generation music in, how do you put it in without being copyrighted, and see what happens. But yeah, but it's not allowed, so I'm gonna come off now and see you guys soon. Love you guys, thank you for supporting me. I just want to do what I want to do on this channel, and that is just to give you guys good content, share my experiences, give the story times, give vlogs, and you know the rest. So like, subscribe, and keep tune with me. Mwah.